With a soccer perspective. This is Soccer Today with Duane Mullins and Kevin Larame, live on the Sports Podcasting Network.
Good day, good night. Welcome to Soccer Today for this special presentation. Today we are joined by one of the nominee for the U21 Canadian Player of the Year Award in the Canadian Premier League, midfielder for York United, number 16, Max Ferrari is joining us today on the show. Max, how are you today?
I'm good. How are you? Thanks for having me.
It's good to have you on, Max. As one of the young players in this league, I'm always curious to ask this question to sort of lead it off. You're of an age where when you were growing up playing soccer, there was no Canadian Premier League. So what did it feel like when you found out that you had this professional league to aspire to in this country? And how did that sort of change your approach at that point?
Yeah. As a kid, obviously growing up, you play CSL, OISL, and then the next step is when you go in Ontario. And then I joined League One Ontario about 16 years old, and about when I was 18, we found out about the CPL being created. And that kind of gave us a buzz where we can make it pro, because that's your goal. And at that point, the only option is MLS. But knowing that the CPL is here and that kind of League One could be that filter, it's exciting. It creates a buzz that Canada soccer is growing, and especially for me, being a York region kid, finding out that York 9 was created, and yeah, it's very exciting.
Look, you mentioned how there is that MLS level there. There's barriers sometimes for that. Like, not everyone's close to the MLS team, so like, do you feel that if for someone that's maybe a little bit younger than you, that there's a better chance or a more open chance for them to aspire to be a professional now that you have the CAMPL around?
Yeah, I think it's kind of that more, because MLS has all these guys coming from international places, they're top players. I think the CPL gives you that chance where you can go from League One to college and go straight to this CPL with having that high quality, great coaches, and just a great atmosphere in general. But it's more like the, I guess I don't want to really say realistic point, but when I was in League One, it gave me that hope that I can go pro sooner than I think.
Speaking of going pro, second season 2021 has gone well for you. Of course, throughout the year, York United has continued to grow and have made the playoffs, finished fourth this year, squeaked by Valor, and were able to get through the finish line. You had a good playoff too in a couple games with an assist, and at the end of this season, you're nominated for one of the U21 Canadian Player of the Year, three nominees, and there's a chance you win that trophy. How would you describe your season in the Canadian Premier League?
For me, obviously, I joined pre-COVID in 2020, so I signed my first contract, and then everything got shut down, so it was kind of that I got halted for a bit. And then having that first season, I didn't really play much. I came on and 7 games, I appeared in 7 all off the bench. So this year, coming into it, I wasn't sure what to expect. Obviously, I had a hard-working off-season. I knew we had a very young team coming in this year, a lot of new guys. I want to say we had about 15 new guys. But yeah, for me, the hardest part was we didn't really have a preseason going into this. We kind of found out early June that we were going to the bubble, and then we had to play. Our first game was end of June, so it was kind of just a quick turnaround for everyone. But as the season went on, for me, I don't think I was really going into the league looking to pick up individual work. I didn't really have that in my mind. I just wanted, at the end of the day, at York, we want to win championships. And with this squad, we were very, people were doubting. People had us all coming last place. And obviously, we were just, for me as an individual and as a team, this whole season was just proving everyone wrong, proving that we can compete. And we actually made playoffs. So for me to get this award, it's just, yeah, it's really nice. But at the end of the day, I just want to win. But yeah, I'd like to thank, like, obviously my coaches, my players for helping me throughout the season, because without that chance of me getting to play that much and to play with all these guys, I wouldn't be able to do it without these guys. So, yeah.
When we're looking at your playing style, of course, this season in 30 matches, playoffs included 3 goals, 4 assists for you as a midfielder. How would you describe your playing style? How would you describe at least the way you would love to be as a midfielder in any league you're playing in?
Yeah, so for me, actually, this year, I bounced around a lot. Most of the time, I was playing on the right wing, but I think it was 10 or so games I filled in at fullback. So my style is pretty direct, as people know if they see me. My first aspect is obviously the playmaking style, obviously being a midfielder, crossing the line. But yeah, this year I played a lot in the fullback. I learned a lot of things out wide. It was a really good year for me. Obviously, next year I want to improve my stats. But, everyone wants to score more goals, get more assists to win games. So yeah, for me, it's just building on what I did good this year and then just getting better for next year.
The KMPL is ultimately a development league. I think every player in the league, every personnel in the league agrees that if you can move to a higher level, that's something that you aspire to. Not that there's anything wrong with playing the KMPL, of course, but everyone's looking right to get as high as they can. How would you describe your goals in your career goals? Where are you looking to get to? Where would you like to see yourself playing one day?
Yeah, I mean, for me, it's throughout my whole life, it's just always getting better. And obviously, I started with rep, and then I pushed up to League One, and then obviously, I want to make that step to CPL. I think everyone in the CPL wants to go higher. Like you said, everyone wants to go higher no matter what. And for me, it's whether going abroad or to the MLS, I just want to push myself to the limit, and I feel like the CPL right now is I'm learning a lot. Like, I'm learning every day. But the good thing about York is we have a lot of good vets that have been around those top leagues and stuff. So I've been learning every day. Like, guys like Mike Petrasso, he's guiding me throughout the whole season. 5 months, he was right beside me, guiding me, helping me out whenever I had a question. He was there. So, yeah, it's that type of stuff. I just look forward to successful.
And, you know, you're going to have a bit of a change next year. You played under Jimmy Brennan, who has moved on, and Paul Stoltieri was the assistant coach. So those are two guys that are, you know, played at the highest levels in Europe. What'd you learn from playing under Jimmy and Paul, and how do you think that their guidance in the past and maybe perhaps in the future will help you get to that next level?
Yeah, I mean, two guys that are very high up in the Canada soccer ranks. Obviously, for me, me and Jimmy, I've known Jimmy since I was about 7 years old. I was attending his camps. He was actually the first guy to tell me that I was going to be a pro footballer. So for me, it was that simple thing to play for a guy for my hometown team. It was that special. And then with Stoltieri, those guys are helping every day. I'm one to ask a lot of questions. So with all them actually playing somewhat of the position I play, it helped me a lot too. So whenever I needed help, and even off the pitch, they're always there for me. So, yeah.
And of course, when you're looking at Canadian soccer, a few decades ago now, Jimmy Brennan, and we saw the pictures of you when you were 7 years old in the Jimmy Brennan soccer school with, of course, Jimmy Brennan with questionable haircuts back in the day. But I guess we were all in a younger situation, Jimmy Brennan included.
Yeah.
But, you know, when you think about the growth of Canadian soccer since then, did you ever think that one of the best player in the world right now, in the world starting 11, would be a Canadian? Does the rise of a player like Alphonso Davies, Jonathan David, and other players in the world playing sometimes at the same position as you are playing, does it influence your thought process? Does it influence or motivate you as a player?
I mean, for me, growing up as a kid, I don't think people thought of Canada soccer. Like, I think when you think of Canada, they think of hockey, right? And me being a soccer player, you always want to see the game grow. And now that a kid my age, two kids my age that are doing really well, it's only good for the game. And I think as the game keeps progressing, like how good the national team's doing, it's good for these young kids because they're all watching. They're all watching their idols, and they want to be like their idols. So, yeah, I think it's only good for the game, obviously, and it inspires me as a kid, the seeing guys my age being able to do what they're doing. It makes me want to do more.
And now when you're looking at next year in the Canadian Premier League, and you mentioned how you want to score more goals, of course, it's an easy statistics to improve when you look at the possibility, and scoring goals is fun. But when you're looking at the possibilities for you as a player for next year, I don't necessarily want you to give us a number, but is there something winning a championship you mentioned already? But what are the motivation that you get every morning? What helps you going to the gym? What helps you maybe add 5 pounds more every day? Those little motivational aspect of being a professional athlete, it's really intrigue me. So what helps you get through the minus 20 cold morning when you have to get through the gym?
I think with us this year, being a part of York, it was kind of the people you're around. And as players, we always want to improve. And when you're coming into the 8 a.m. every morning with a bunch of guys that you enjoy to be with on and off the field, it kind of motivates you that much more. And obviously, we touched on we want to win championships here. And, yeah, we want to compete in that conference. We want to go far in the Canadian championship. But for us, it's always about reaching those goals. So, I think it just comes from wanting to succeed as everyone, and that comes from our leaders, and they were great. We were so close off the field. This is the closest I've been with any group, and that just helps draw on the field motivation, I think.
Max, you had this year. We had the first proper derby in this country in 25 years this year when York played TFC, of course, in the Canadian Championship. That game down at BMO and the potential of having other opportunities to match up with the big bad red team in town here.
Yeah.
How does that motivate you? Is that something that gets the folks up at York excited and energetic to maybe pull an upset off one day against that team?
I mean, yeah, I think from 2020, when we saw the draw that we were going to play Masters and that opportunity was to play TFC in the next round, that's the matchup you want. You want to play the best players. You want to play those guys like Bradley, Altidore, Osorio. We want to play those guys. So then this year when we saw the draw come out and we had to play beat Master winner that plays TFC, everyone wants to be in that game. So, it was just like an unbelievable experience. Obviously, it wasn't the result we wanted, but going to BMO Field, playing in front of those guys, playing against those guys, it was just something that I'll remember. Because at the end of the day, me growing up as a York Region kid, I was a TFC fan. I would call myself a Toronto FC supporter. So it's just, it was a special experience.
Pretty cool, yeah. I'm going to wrap up with this. I want to talk a bit about, go back to the development side of things. You mentioned how you went up that ladder. You played at the highest level of youth soccer, then you moved to League One Ontario, which is a level that may not be familiar to people outside of Ontario, but is certainly a very, very high level of the game. And then that jump to the pros. How big was that jump? How much of an adjustment was it for you to go from Aurora to playing at York? How hard is it to make that jump up?
Honestly, it was really hard. It was way harder than I would have thought. So me playing at the youth, I always thought I was one of the fitter guys. We do fitness tests. I did well. And then when I went to York, I signed with York. We did a fitness test, and I came dead last. And it was kind of just like a reality check where that was the first thing that came out to me. It was, wow, these are pros. And then And then coming into training every day. These guys do it every day, these top players. Like last year when I was playing with Manuel Aparicio, Mike Petrasso, Chris Minella, these guys are good every day in training. And that's something you just have to adjust with. You're in there 6 days a week, and it's tiring. It's more mentally tiring. And, yeah, for me, that jump, it was huge. And it was more of a reality check, but it made me a better player, because right when – I found out though, I had to obviously lose weight. I changed my diet. I changed my mentality. So it helped me for the better.
Yeah, changing the diet, losing weight. It's been the journey I've started also recently, which brings me to this question, Max, because I go to the gym every morning. And for me, there's exercise that I love more than others. And when I get to leg day, I'm not that happy. And, we're all like this. What exercise or what training exercise or the gym, regardless which one it is, do you like the most, and which one do you hate the most?
For me, I'm not really a big upper body guy. I'm not the biggest guy, so the bench press isn't great. I probably should be working on that. But yeah, I like to be on the treadmill. I like squats. I'd probably say I like working my lower body out better than my upper body. So yeah.
Awesome. I love the squats too. When you know, I'll work on my step ups too. Step ups are fun, but not necessarily when you're doing them. Before we say goodbye for today, you mentioned Michael Petrasso, and I had the chance to cover Michael Petrasso when he was playing for Montreal a few years ago. And there's a famous moment where Zlatan Ibrahimovic slaps Michael Petrasso, gets a red card. And you've played with Michael Petrasso for a year, and I wonder if Michael Petrasso talks about that moment. And did he give maybe some behind the scenes of how is it to play in Major League Soccer?
Honestly, me being close to Mike, I see him every day. I even roomed with him a lot, even the bubble and away trips. Everyone knows that it happened, and we don't really talk about it. No one's really mentioned it. I think it's just a topic that we haven't really talked about. I don't know. Yeah, it's just something that hasn't really come up, I'm really honest.
No, and he's a great human being, and it was always fun to cover him in Major League Soccer. And when you're looking at him, and you've talked about him and a couple of the players, and you look at what they do day in, day out, and you measure yourself, and you mention how you adjusted your diet and you adjusted a few different things to lead you to this U21 nominee for the Canadian Premier League in the 2021 season. What is the next step in your training, and what is the next aspect of your professional footballer career that you would love to better?
For me, I think just improving on what I'm doing. Obviously, I think I need to improve in a lot of things, but that all comes from the mentality you have off the field. And if you want to be serious, taking your diet seriously, taking your sleep seriously, everything. I just want to improve everything. A lot of in game I want to do, and then obviously physically I want to change a couple things, but on the pitch wise, do I want to change anything? I'm looking forward to next season, and that's really it. I'm looking forward to preseason with York, and then
Well, we're looking forward to seeing you play next season with York United, of course, at York Lions Stadium. It's just a rock throw away from downtown Toronto, a great place to watch some soccer next season. We're looking forward to it. We're wishing you a great off season, and of course, all the best of luck with the U21 award, and we're rooting for you, Max.
Thank you.
And we'll say goodbye for today. Thank you to York United for organizing this interview. Thank you for Max Ferrari for his time today. And of course, you can follow York on all the social media. Look for Max, great soccer player, Canadian, not just the future, it's right now. Canadian soccer is here, it's right now, and it's fun to watch. And York United is a fun team to keep an eye on, an up-and-coming team. Who knows, maybe Cavalry, and especially Pacific, will get some challenge next year. Of course, until then, you can follow myself on social media at 24th Minute for Duane, at Kev Larame for myself. And until next time, I'm Kev Larame. This is Soccer Today, and have a great soccer.
You can find the podcast version of all the shows we do on iTunes, Apple Podcast, Google Play Store, TuneIn Radio, iHeartRadio, and anywhere you get your podcast.